Hey guys, what's up? Welcome to another video. I'm the WPress Doctor and today we will be talking about Elementor Pro and Divi. What are the differences between them? How good are they? And can you make a wrong decision in buying each one of them? I'm gonna give you my honest opinion about both of them. I've been building in WordPress since 2001 and since 2004 in WordPress, so I think I can shed a little bit of light on this subject. We're going to compare both packages on seven subjects: the learning curve, the possibilities or the modules, the pricing, team dependency, templates, support and speed. I think these are the most important differences between the two packages. Okay, let's first talk about the learning curve. I think that both Divi and Elementor Pro are very good learnable for even if you have never touched a computer before. Well, that's not completely true. If you can manage your Windows or your Mac, you can learn Divi or Elementor Pro. However, there is a steep learning curve. In 2014, I started to build with Divi, so I'm a long-time Divi user. When I started to use Elementor Pro, it was a bit hard for me because all the things were different. However, other people which are used to Elementor Pro start using Divi and they say the same. It's a little bit hard for me. Also, a friend of mine came from Wix and he started building something in Elementor Pro and started building something in Divi. And he said it was both very hard for me. So the learning curve is absolutely the same on both Divi and Elementor Pro. You just have to stick to it, watch a lot of tutorials, and then you can learn both of them. So I'm giving both packages a 6 because it's not that easy, but it is learnable. All right, let's talk about the possibilities and the modules. They both come with a lot of modules and a lot of possibilities. In my experience, and I'm building websites every single day, is that Elementor Pro has just thought out things a little bit better. So for example, if you want a divider with a bar with it and an icon in it, Divi cannot get that out of the box and Elementor Pro can. If you want, for example, to have a headline and you want to be animated or typed, Divi doesn't have that. Elementor Pro has it out of the box. So yes, there are small differences that sometimes you'll notice that, Elementor Pro is just a little bit better in this certain area. So I'm gonna give Elementor Pro a 10 out of 10 and Divi, I'm gonna give it a 9 because it's also very good, but it can do better. So let's talk about the price. Pricing with Divi and Elementor Pro is very, very different. Divi has, for example, a lifetime license, which is excellent. If you want to build a lot of websites or you're going to be a web building agency, then Divi is the way to go because you only pay once for your entire life, which is excellent if you want to create more and more and more websites because your license is infinite. You can use API keys with Divi to build unlimited websites. However, with Elementor Pro, the price tag is a little bit different. With Elementor Pro, if you want to build unlimited websites, well, you have to pay $1,000 a year. So it's not one time, it is yearly. If you're just building one website for yourself, then you can buy Elementor Pro just for the price of $50. But after 4 years, you're at $200 and, well, you know what I'm getting at. So on the price, I'm gonna give Divi a 9 and I'm gonna give Elementor Pro a 5 because I still really think they need a lifetime license. All right, let's talk about theme dependency. I hated Elementor Pro and here is why. You always had to buy another theme or download a free theme, which eventually always broke. I always got clients which says, well, Elementor is working, but the theme has been discontinued and now things are starting to break. It was my one point of extreme frustration with Elementor Pro. But that is just gone because a few months ago they released the Hello theme, which is a theme created by the guys of Elementor. Problem solved. This theme is excellent. I'm really excited about this because now finally I don't have to be dependable on third-party theme developers. With Divi, it is already a theme. You download it and you have everything. So I'm gonna give both Divi and Elementor Pro 10 out of 10 because Elementor Pro has done a great job what Divi did since 2014. So proud of you guys at Elementor, well done. Next subject is the templates. It's really easy to grab a template, change it, and then create your own style with this template. Both Divi and Elementor Pro did a really good job with it. However, there is a little bit of difference with Divi and Elementor Pro. And the difference is that all the templates created by Divi are actually more of the same, in my experience. The reason why is that the Divi templates has been created by one single party, and that is Elegant Themes itself. Of course, you can download other themes from other people, but it's not that easy with Elementor Pro. With Elementor Pro, you can just upload a plugin, go to a marketplace, and download free templates all around. And I know templates is not that important because you create your website yourself, like me, but we're gonna count it anyway. I'm gonna give Divi a 8 on this and Elementor Pro a 9. Let's talk about support. If you're talking about Divi and support, I give it a straight 10 out of 10 because it's amazing. When you log in, you ask a question, within an hour or 2 hours, I have a reply. And that is great. And they really helped me out. They're really trying to satisfy you. And it's amazing because I bought a lifetime license years ago. Actually, they don't make any money on me, but they're still helping me out. And that is really cool. I'm really proud of them. With Elementor Pro, my experience is not that good. When I ask a question, you really have to wait some time. That's why they have a premium support now. So you can actually ask a question. They will help you even further, but you have to pay more money for it. So on support, I think Elementor Pro can't match Divi. So I'm gonna give Divi a 10 and Elementor Pro a 8. The last thing I want to talk to you about is speed. And I'm not talking about speed on the front end, because both Divi and Elementor Pro can be really fast for your visitors. That's easy. You just follow my tutorials about speeding up Divi and speeding up Elementor, and it just works excellent. But I'm talking about speed on the back end when you're trying to build your website. Because there is actually a difference there. For example, when you're switching from Divi in your mobile view, 2 to 3 seconds to fully load it in your browser. With Elementor Pro, you just click it and it's right there. And that is, for now, that is still a big difference. You guys are very patient. I know I'm just a guy that wants to speed, speed, speed. But to give it a score, I would say Divi would get a 7 and Elementor Pro would get a 9. You didn't hear it from me, but they're actually rebuilding Divi from the ground up so that speed is way better than what it is right now. So as a conclusion of this video, we've talked about a lot of different things. Whatever you choose, you cannot go wrong with both of them, because I give Divi a 59 score and Elementor Pro a 57. They're really close to each other. However, there are a few small things that Elementor Pro has done better than Divi. However, the support and the pricing of Divi is better than Elementor Pro. So it's still up to you. So if you want to buy Divi or Elementor Pro, I would be very thankful if you use the affiliate links provided in the description of this video, or just go to wp.discount. And this is my website, and I've created a tab which says page builders. And here you can just go with Elementor Pro or Divi. And now you always know if there is a discount going on with Divi or with Elementor Pro. If there is no discount, like with Elementor Pro right now, you will just see it bluntly, 0% discount, because I hate it when people say there's a discount and there's an affiliate link, and I hate it. So if I helped you out in this video, hit that like button so I know I was on the right track. And if you have comments or questions, drop them down, of course, below this video. Subscribe if you want to see more WordPress related videos. Guys, thank you very much. I wish you an awesome day.